I'm recording cause I can. Gonna empty the harvester out. Gonna get it all fixed up. I'm gonna sell these greasy crops. I'm all done with this farm. I don't know why that song's going through my head today. Well, it's not that it's a bad song or anything. It's better than like a Madonna song or something. Sorry to all you Madonna fans out there. I don't think I probably have too many Madonna fans on my channel. There might be a couple though. But I think since like 90% of my viewers are guys, 94% are guys. There's probably not a whole huge like people lining up to beat me up with a baseball bat because I don't like Madonna. Yuck.
Like a surgeon.
At Weird Al. You gotta love Weird Al and his sense of humor. Alright, so we're gonna wash everything. Let's wash them up. Yep. This is gonna be really hard to steer, but we can do it. Because that was realistic. Alright, so let's get this tangle jangled. It's gonna fall apart on me. Alright, so let's go in here. Yeah, well, at least it doesn't, it bugs out, but it doesn't, like break. So that's good. I didn't crash the game. Maybe I should save my game before I start winging that thing around like that. Okay, let's save. Whoop. Good. All right, so we're going to move forward. Let's get this guy fixed first up. We're going to repair nothing. $54 on the body. Gearbox. Wait, what's this? 6 euros for nothing. Oil change. Okay, whatever. $9 for the bearings are wearing down. We're going to work on that. $21 for our electrics. And we're good. So, let's go ahead and pull forward. Check out this thing. Looking good. Nope, nothing. Everything looks good. This is still dirty, though. We must have to pull it in separately, I guess. I don't know. We'll try to get the Nabstrooper. Ah, I pressed the wrong button. I didn't really press the wrong button. I forgot to press the brake, like, when I stopped, and so it kept rolling, and that was, like, making it screw up. So I'm going to pull further in and see if I can car wash the header. Otherwise, I may have to attach it to the harvester and then back in and do it. I don't know. It says empty, enter. And then if I get this thing in here, let's see if the enter comes back up. Nope. That's a little bogus. Maybe like this. Wash my machine. Did it clean the header? Nope. Aw, dang. So, we're going to have to back out. Which is not too bad since I'm great at it. So what we're going to do is Q. And we're going to... And we're going to come around and grab the header. And we're going to attach it to the harvester and then back in. We're going to get that whole unit in the wash. And that will hopefully help prevent rust. We don't really need to do that, but I like to keep my stuff clean. You guys know. Come on, you've been watching my channel for years, most of you. Some of you. I actually got a lot of new people. This series has brought in a lot of new viewers. So Farm Sim 15, I found the washer early on in the game and went nuts. And ever since then, I've been washing all my equipment. So there we go. Nice and clean. Ready to go for next year. Or actually the end of the year. I don't know how long. We don't have a timing on the peas and stuff, so I'd rather wait. Ah. I think we're going to do a canola. Yeah, because we got straw. So, I don't know. I'm thinking ahead, but at some point in the next day or two, we're going to plant canola. And at the end of the year, see, I don't know if peas are a winter crop either, so I think we might just wait and not plant a winter crop. But Arthur, you're crazy. Well, no, hear me out. We're going to wait until next year, and then we'll plant peas and soybeans and see how we do with harvesting those. All right. Did I miss it? I must have missed it. Sometimes this trailer gets a little funky, and I can't connect it unless I reset it. So you can see here, I've done something that it's not allowing me to connect to it. It just won't do it. I don't know what I did, but it doesn't like me anymore. And it seems to be when you have the crapsicles. Ah. Oh wait. Oh. I saw it for a sec. So let Oh, dang it. Come on. Q. There we go. I knew it was there. All right, so. I say that all the time. All right, so. I'm trying to fill in the empty spaces with words. All right, so we're going to around here like we did before, and we're going to park the header. We're going to catch the header on this wall, and we'll never get it off. Actually, I can't put it there because Arthur.
Could you get it on the field, get around, drip it off
there? Well, that looked real. Okay. Okay. And we're dropping it off right there. Cue. Done. Bye. Good. Okay, so it's a little bit out, but that's okay. It's all right. I went the wrong way, but that's okay because I need to make a U-turn anyway. Oh man, I am just—it's 1:30. I still haven't gone to bed because I'm real excited about buying the fruit farm. Probably more excited than I should be. We're almost there, Arthur. 20 more minutes, and we'll be done. Shutter off. Jump out. There we go. Harvester's done. Maintained. Put away. Perfect. Okay, so let's get into fruit farming. I am going to take this load down. We're going to stop at the agro shop. Where did it go? Where's my trailer of grain? It's over here. I can hear the tractor. I left the tractor running because I'm so smart. All right, I'll be back. I'm going to run this down, and I'll see you in a minute. All right, we've arrived at the grain silo. Time to finish this up. So my back window's missing. No, it's missing. It's there. It's hard to tell. Real disappointing there. Wow, like nothing. 30% trailer. About $3,000-$4,000 there, so not much to write home about. But that's wheat. It's not worth very much. So unlike, I mean, in the farm sim, it's not worth very much either. But it's worth even much less here. So. The nice thing about this trailer is that I can actually run the tractor at 40 kilometers an hour, and it's not doing the trailer dance. It's actually just riding along with me, so that's nice. We're going to run over to the agro store here. We're going to sell the cows, buy some new ones, sell the cheap goats, chickens, buy some new ones. We should make a nice little profit. It won't be like super duper, but I think we'll probably make $10,000 or $15,000. So then we'll have lots of money to spend. We're going to run down, let's see, map. The fruit farm. Is there an agricultural store nearby? Yeah, there's a dealer. The fruit farm's a long way away. There is a dealer over there. So we're going to, instead of going to our normal dealers, we're going to go across town. man, it's going to take a while. Okay. So first we're going to go to the agricultural store, though, and take care of this end of stuff. So it's nice. So I can actually travel along the roads at full speed without losing the trailer or hopping all over the place. I like that. So let's go ahead and hop into the agricultural store. And I just totally got tangled on the fence. That's great. Farm shop. All right. Once again, people tell me every video. But Arthur, you can buy it from the map. Let me show you something, folks. I want you to pay attention here. How much does a cow cost here at the farm shop? It's 388 euros. Now watch this. If I go to the map... Oops, I can't do it because I'm on that. If I go to the map and I look at the agricultural store, which is here, and I go to the cows, look at that. €2,082 for a cow purchased through the map. Once again, $1,388, almost $700 more to buy that cow through the map. Do not, I repeat, do not buy anything by pressing map and clicking on the farm shop. You are paying almost 70%, or I'm sorry, almost 50% more than what the original cost is. You're paying so much more to do it through the map. Don't do it that way. Actually drive to the store and hit the enter key and buy it that way. Don't do it through the map. That's why I never do it. People are always like, why don't you do that? It's you can't do it that way because you're getting ripped off. Okay, so we're selling all of our aminals. Chickens, the cows were the big sell. Horses are, well, the horses are good too. 5,000. And we're going to buy them all back again. So we're going to go back, we're going to exit, and we're going to enter the farm shop. And we're going to go to the aminals, and we're going to buy this. The horses make big money. Big, big, big money. So you'll notice that I bought a horse. I sold the horses for 5,000 a piece. They cost 1,000 each. So whereas the cows make you money all year, the horses don't make you any money until you sell them. But they all make good money. So it's worth having the horses, and I may even expand the horse because that's a lot of money. They make me a lot of money at the end of the year. So we had how much? We had $156,000. We now have $188,000. So we made almost $30,000 on our base animal farm. Once again, I haven't done any upgrades to the animal farm, so that's good money. All right, so once again, don't buy from the agricultural shop on the map. Actually drive to the agricultural shop. I know people are like, don't do it. Just buy it through the map. Don't buy it through the map. You're paying way more money. Okay, so let's go ahead and that's why I do what I do. Okay, let's go ahead and head over to our next stop is going to be, and I need to mark it on the map because I'll get lost. We need to go to the fruit farm. Let's get there. It's about 10 minutes away. I'm gonna zap over there and I'll meet you guys there, okay? And all I'm telling you from watching the videos, all I'm telling you is that we are about to make a lot of freaking money. It's people are saying it's overpowered. I tend to agree. From the amount of money I saw these guys bringing in when they were done with their harvests, this is the first thing that you want to buy. Don't start the animal farm first. Start the fruit farm. So there's the farm over there. Unfortunately, we have to drive all over the place. But the nice thing is, it's going to need its own tractors and stuff. So there'll be vehicles parked over here. You're not going to have to make this drive every time you have to come down here. So that'll be nice. But we're going to do some shopping. I'd also like to it's getting so late. It's almost 2 o'clock in the morning. I have to go to bed. We're going to get the equipment put together, and then I got to go to bed. I can't do any actual farming. We'll pick that up in the next exciting episode of what is now becoming Fruit Farm. So here is the facility. Yep. We're going to buy it. Yep. How much? $100,000. That leaves us with $88,000 for equipment. I don't know if it's going to be enough, to be honest with you, because the equipment's like super expensive. We need to grab used equipment. We need to go here first, and then we'll go down to... gosh, why does everything have to be opposite sides? Yeah. I need to go to both. So I want to check the used equipment out first. Congratulations. Good luck figuring out what you're supposed to do. Good thing there's this big mountain range right in the middle of where I have to go. Let's do some tractor off-roading. We'll have a little off-road adventure on our way over to the fruit farm. So much for going to bed early. I've blown. Actually, though, tomorrow's kind of my Saturday, if you will. I've been working all week with working weekends and weeks. So I did take last Saturday off, though. I didn't do anything last Saturday, but once I start playing this game, I almost can't stop. It's like the Farm Sim, really, a lot. I really like this game. I'm sorry, guys, that you don't love some of the guys. I know I've got a couple people that are like, don't play this game anymore. It sucks. And I'm like, no. First of all, the videos are doing really good. All my stats across YouTube have gone through the roof. This is helping my channel a lot. And that's good for you guys that like the Farm Sim. What, Ryan? No. Viewers are all allowed to their opinions. And if you don't like the videos, if you don't like this series, don't watch them. Just watch the series that you like. There will be more. Sometimes you might have to wait a little bit, but this is a new game. I'm excited about it, and I'm having fun. Let me have fun. That's what this is about, isn't it? I mean, you having fun too, but everybody should have fun. And I need to have fun, otherwise I'm not doing it. All right, so here we go. Boop. So we need to look at Orchard. Nope. That's for harvesting trees, planting trees. We do need one of these, though. And this, how much is this? 20,000? So, we're going to buy this. Mods, nothing, other. Tango wrapper, nope, other, nope. We should buy one of these eventually, too, because it'll make our bales worth more when we sell them. Orchard, sprayers, nope. Fertilizers and sprayers, nope. Nope. Okay. So let's go ahead. There's our little tractor. We're going to leave that parked there for now. And we're going to go to this store across the map. Of course, it has to be on, once again over the mountain range, which we'll tackle with Fever. Actually, it's not too steep of a mountain range, so. What'd you say, kid? Whoa! In Europe somewhere, I'm sure. Italy. I was at my... That was the tractor dealership. Is that what you're asking? I'm buying stuff for the... Ah! Yeah, it is cool. I'm buying stuff for the greenhouses. That's not the way to go. Help! I thought this would be an adventure that turns into a disaster. Let's see. All right, let's see if we can get down here without dying. Yeah, I'd done some crawling. Oh, I love the way the wheel didn't turn when it was off the ground. Did you see that? Like the one wheel didn't end, like it wasn't... Oh, man, it's so steep here. Oh, I don't know. This might be too much. Oh, there's no way. There's no way. That would not be happening in real life, but we did it. All right, that was fun. Not too realistic, but fun nonetheless. So full steam ahead. Rand's brushing his toodles. With the Sonicare brush by Philips. Hey, where's my product placement money? Come on. Dang it, these mountains are like blocking all the shops. I have to drive all the way around. Like, they look like they're close, but they're not. It's a lie. At least there's a gas station nearby. So this farm has a gas station nearby. And obviously the shops, but the shops are on the other sides of the Mootins. So we're going to cut through. I got to go to bed. I'm sorry, I'm rushing, guys. Usually I would just take the roads, but... keep them wheels rocking. There's a pterodactyl up there. That looked like a pterodactyl. Aha! There's the shop. Eek. And there's an agricultural center next to it, so that's good. Whoa. All right. Sweet. Handled like a champ. My four-wheel drive tractor. In real life, I think the tractor would have tipped right over. I don't think you can do that with tractors in real life. Pretty sure that they're not. I mean, they're all-wheel drive and stuff, but they don't. I don't think you can. I mean, you can use them on hills and stuff, but they're not really meant for that kind of aggressive use. All right, so I'm going to park it right here. Let's go into the store. Aw, yeah. $68,000 left. We got one of the tractors that we need. We need to get Orchard. Six Pebble. This thing is one of the things that we need. Greenhouse platform. How much? 14,000. Man. This is going to be 19,000. That's not too bad. I thought it was going to be a lot more expensive than that. Orchard sprayer. And we have an orchard tractor too. We can do like double duty there. Fruit crates. Working with 6 4-centimeters, 6 centimeters. We'll take... this is the bigger one. They're the same price. I don't know why you'd get the smaller one. Okay, so we need to get this for sure to start with. I don't know if we're going to have enough. We need that for sure. We need this for sure. 32,000 left. Oh, it's going to be so close. We need to have the platform. This is 14,000. Oh, I need to move stuff off the... there's things on the... I got to move this stuff so I can buy that other stuff. Look, Ryan. See that little thing? It's for spraying the... it's the tractor that you use inside the orchard. What, Ryan? Wait, I pushed it forward. It's not going backwards. What? I can't go forwards with it. Hmm. Bugs. I mean, this has to be able to pull this, right? Hang on. All right. Well, anyway, we'll work on that in a sec. I've watched people use them in the video, so I know it works. What was I buying? What else did I have to get? Other orchard. We need the platform. And last but not least, we need the unloader, the trailer. I can't buy it because I can't pull it off, so... wow. Alright, so we're going to... T, begin spraying. It's empty! Of course it's empty. That's funny. Okay. Well, that sucks. Maybe they'll pull this. I don't know. I need to get the tractor to pull that. I don't know. This does actually run on gas, so that's interesting. Hey, there's the pebble. Well, pull these forward. Calls them pebbles. Look, there's people riding on there, Ryan. It's funny. They're looking around for stuff to harvest. All right, you pebble, hang out here. All right, so let's go ahead and start this up. See if we can pull this thing over with this. I don't think that this is going to be able to attach to that, but we'll see. I'm guessing no. But maybe. If we can, we'll pull it over, and hopefully it'll work when we get under the flat surface there. Nope. Nope. Okay, so this tractor's done with. Oh, I need to turn it off. I'm going to send it home. So we don't need this anymore. So we're going to say go home for this guy. Boop. And let's see. Map. We're going to grab. Oh, no. I want to go into the store. What am I doing? No. Enter. There we go. And we're going to go to Orchard once again. And last but not least, we need to get the trailer so we can load the fruit carts on them and take them to the store. They're the same, but this is much wider. Okay. These guys. All right, slaves, come on. Oh, another slave joke. It's just bad. Stop it, Arthur. Oh. See, that this one, it did jump back again, but this time I can get this one going, so that's cool. Woohoo! Celebrate good times, come on! Do-do-do-do. It's this thing doesn't steer good. I think it's going too fast. Let's try to put it on CVT 2. That seems a little more realistic there, huh? 3? Can we do it? Alright, guys, hold on! Woohoo! Oh no, don't hit the tree! Oh no. Oh, what was I thinking? It seemed like a good idea, but. Alright, let's hit it again. So 3 seems to be the speed that you can run at. 4 is right out, dangerous. So we're going to have to take these guys all the way over. This is going to take forever. That little tractor, I might grab that little tractor, the other one, and use that to ferry this other stuff back and forth. Here's where the farm sim has this game beat. You can use a truck for delivery. You can actually rent a truck and, well, buy a truck. Using the mods, you can rent them. And you could just run it over. That'd be a big benefit to be able just to deliver this. But that's all the equipment that you need for the fruit farming, and it was a lot. I mean, we spent $180,000 today, but I'm telling you, we're gonna make it back pretty freaking quick. Now, I'm gonna have to wait, unfortunately, probably till next year to do. Because I don't have any money left. So, it's a 90-day growth period. I think, we'll see how much seeds are, but we'll try to get some done if we can. But I have a feeling 3,000 is not going to be enough. We might be able to plant them like in a couple, maybe towards the middle of the month we'll try planting and see what happens. This thing is ridiculous. And I think I need to slow down time again, because we're now dealing with more things that we have to do, so we're going to save our game, too, just in case. You know how things go. Oops. What happened? I think it shut the tractor off. That's weird. This thing is so cute. It's a cute little tractor. But this way you're not getting all kinds of pollutants inside the greenhouse, you know? So, for year 5 and year 6, we'll be messing around with the fruit farm, having fun there. Along with the same normal things that we do on the regular farm. The fresh fruits, I'm not sure what this place is. Let's take a look. I think this is all part of our thing. Yeah, this is the same thing. It allows for sale of fruit. So maybe we can sell stuff there. I don't know. It doesn't look like a sale point, but maybe it is. So we don't have to drive around. This thing's kind of hard to steer. Oh, it's horrible. So now that we own this, can we open these garages? I wonder if we can store stuff in here. Nope. But I did see a storage shed around the corner here. I'm wondering where we should park this stuff when we're not using it. I think, yeah, that's it over there. So let's take this over here. We could probably even just store it. Nah, there's not a whole lot of room in there, though. We'll just see what's over here. So this thing's terrible, the handling, but it's kind of funny. I don't mind it because it's just ridiculous. Alright, so here's where we can store our stuff. There's a gate. Hopefully the gate will open for us now that we own it. I don't know that it will, though. Maybe it doesn't. Nope. Well, that's interesting. That's kind of, to me, that's kind of a bug, but I guess maybe that's privately owned over there? I don't know. Okay, well that sucks. So literally, you can't... This is other people's farms and houses. You can't put your stuff here. So we're going to have to put our trailer in a... Hello, fellas. The good news is we haven't used any gas on that trip over here, so that means this thing's going to be... Hopefully fairly efficient. I'm not that good. I'm trying to steer this thing. Nope. Alright, so there we go. Now we got them. There's crap all over my warehouse floor. Alright, so we're going to park this trailer here. And park this little guy here. Actually, we probably want to move that, huh? Because that's going to need to be... Yeah, we just need to make it neater. Because the thing is, when we get... We're going to have to be fertilizing these... I love the way the guys hop on when you do this. It's so funny. Everybody want to get on? We're going to back up now. I can't see because of the camera. Oh, it leaves little tire tracks. I'm so easily pleased. All right. All right, so there we go. We're going to drop this here and stop here and turn it off. And now let's look at our map. We're going to jump into the cute little tractor that we bought at the used tractor. Hop on that. There we go. I don't know if this thing's going to be able to tow those other trailers. I'm hoping it does. But this thing goes real slow, too. Ugh. All right, so I'm going to run over there. I'll be back. This only holds 34 liters. Holy cow. I'm going to be running out of gas all the time. All right, see you in a minute. All right, so the good news is the sprayer can connect to the small tractor. It's not exactly pretty. Look at that. It's hanging the back wheels. But at least we can get it over to the... What is that? It's a sprayer. Like a fertilizer. So we have a whole host of things that we're going to have to learn. Like what this fills up with. What we need to spray all those things with, like, do you just spray it with fertilizer, and since they're inside, you don't have to do antifungal and stuff like that, or, I don't know, we'll find out, huh? But right now I'm being very rough with my brand new equipment, and this is not the best solution, but it's a solution. It's better than nothing, right? All right, so I'm going to finish delivering these things. I'll be back.